So hello for this lesson about sampling distribution. So now, first of all, we have a population which is have a huge number of elements. This is our total population. For example, total number of products, total number of students in university, and this is our sample, which is only very a few number of elements from the total population. So why should we take sample? Because our population is sometimes infinite product or element in a production line. Maybe our population is very huge, or it will be very tedious and very hard task to perform our test in the whole population. So the solution is only to take sample of a sample size n. So we take a random sample, which is only few elements from the population. The sample could be only 10 elements, maybe 15, 30. So this is the sample size, which is called n. So now let's have a look for the population and the sample. The population is our huge amount of products or people or something. For the population, we have the main two parameters, which are the mean. We have the symbol mu for the mean. The mean is an important measure for the central tendency, as we have seen. Also, the variance is the main or the most important measure for the variability. We have the population variance, which is called sigma square. We also, in fact, have the population standard deviation, which is only sigma. So after that, we have a random sample from the population. The sample size will be n, which is a small sample size, for example, n 10, 12, 15, 20 element. So the sample will also have a mean and a variance. But for the sample mean, we call this like x bar. So x bar is the sample mean. Also the variance of the sample called s square. We also have the standard deviation of the sample, which is can be also called like s. So to introduce our sampling, we have what is called central limit theorem. In fact, our population could be distributed in different manners. So our population could be like maybe normally distributed, or maybe uniformly or exponentially. So maybe we don't have also some more exact information about the distribution of our population. But in fact, the central limit theorem says that whatever the data is distributed in our population, we will look for the sample mean, which is x bar. So x bar itself, in fact, has a normal distribution. So the x bar distribution has a mean value of mu, which is the population mean value, and has a variance of sigma square over n. So in fact, the variance of the x bar depends on the sample size. So in fact, this, if you need to have more information about the central limit theorem, and this is also called the unbiased estimator or the minimum variance unbiased estimator, maybe you should refer to some books about statistics. But in fact, here as a summary, we summarize that the x bar or the sample mean is the best measure to the population mean. We have the sample mean, or the expected value of the sample mean exactly equals the mu, which is the population mean. So this is called the unbiased estimator. So unbiased estimator, which is x bar, if the expected value of x bar would be exactly equal to the mu or the mean value of the population. We also have x bar to be the minimum variance unbiased estimator, because among other estimators for the mean value, the x bar will be always having the minimum variance, which is sigma squared divided by n. So as I have said, if you need more information about the central limit theorem, about the minimum variance and biased estimator, maybe you should refer to some other statistics books. But as a conclusion, I can conclude that the X bar is the best estimator that we can estimate the mean value of the population. So a revise and have a quick review about the sample mean and the sample variance, and how can we calculate the sample mean and sample variance. For the sample mean, so this will be very easy. We have the summation of all elements and divide by the number of sample. So we sum over all elements in the sample and divide by the number of sample, which will give us the average or the mean value of our sample. To get the variance of our sample, we have this formula. In fact, this formula is computationally expensive, which needs a lot of computation. So this one to the right is more simplified. So first of all, we sum the squares of elements in our sample. Here we have the summation of all sample, and after that we square, and we know that n is the number of elements in our sample. So we use these equations to compute the sample mean and sample variance. We will use this computation in our hypothesis testing later.